Well, hello, 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 everyone, and festive greetings to you all for the month. And my word, it's crazy, isn't it? We're getting towards the Christmas time of year, but it's an immense pleasure to have your company here today on the Alan's Music Centre YouTube channel, where we play lots of wonderful music and also explore a fantastic organ that we have available to tempt you with. And for those of you who don't know me, my name is Tom. I work here at Alan's Music. And today we are playing the fantastically beautiful Ringway Maestro, which is a gorgeous, gorgeous machine. Beautiful cabinet, lovely sounds, as you've just heard. And this is actually not only our latest flagship model, but we had a big hand in actually helping design this brand new home organ for the world, and lots of very happy people with these out there already. And of course, the big highlight of today's live stream is that we have our very first pre-owned Maestro just become available. The owner of this absolutely adored it, but as people just like to change sometimes, he's moved on to a different instrument. So we have our very first one back available. So it's going to be great fun playing lots of Christmas songs and also answering your questions. But we're to say hello, first of all, to the gang. Oh, in case you're wondering, I'm on my own today. Not only am I back on the live streams after several weeks of being absent, but have been out busy delivering organs for young Tam and various places, been making journeys. Yes, Trevor is out today visiting a customer, and he was hoping to be back, but the demonstration was a bit more in depth than he was planning for, but the gentleman's very happy. In fact, he's actually been to show someone around their new Maestro today, so the gentleman's very, very pleased with it. And so yes, but Trevor sends his best wishes to all. So we've got Ernie on. Hello to you, Ernie. Welcome, welcome, welcome. David in Penzance. Hi, Tom, and all on the channel. Fortunately, I have to go out this afternoon, so we'll be looking forward to catching up later. Sure will be an interesting session on the Maestro. Yes, David is a very proud owner of a Maestro. I'm sure he won't mind me saying that. Steve Homer. Morning, Steve. Still got 6 inches of frozen snow. Wow, Steve, you got Cambridge. We've been quite lucky here in on the east coast of England. We haven't had a huge amount of snow here. It's been very icy, but nothing white yet. So John Sinkovich is on. Hello, John. Sue King there, of course. And we've got Graham Williams. Afternoon, everyone. Greetings from Norway from Nino Kolas, I think you pronounce. Anyway, hello, hello, Nino. Welcome to our live stream. Philip Russell had 4 centimetres of snow, but not enough to make driving down the hill. Okay, yes, Philip lives on a hill. I live on a hill, Philip, yes. Actually, I went out the other morning and literally the road was like a skating rink. I mean, it took me about a minute to drive from that side of the wall to here, the distance from my road to the junction, because every time I pushed my foot on the accelerator, the wheels just span round. It was just crazy. Paul Barnes is on from Snowy Chatham. Season's greetings to everyone at Allen's, and also Anthony Baytop and Jeannie. Hello, Jeannie, nice to see you all. So a very, very warm welcome to you. And so yes, greetings to you all. And I say today we're going to be exploring the wonderful Lowry, sorry, not Lowry, because he keeps saying that, force of habit, you know, the Ringway Maestro. So the story of the Maestro is this builds on the immense popularity of the Ringway range. Now, the history of Ringway goes back many decades, and for a short period, they had a collaboration with the Orla company in Italy, and they produced 2 or 3 very fine instruments which had Orla sounds in them. So we had the RS-1000, which is the white organ, the black RS-600, and also the 480 was before that. And those were beautiful organs, but of course, Ringway, moving on from that, produced their own instruments. So we've been very proud to introduce to Europe the A2000, the RS-800, and the 760, and lots of many happy customers with those. But as people obviously have Lowry organs and different instruments, they say, hey, it'd be nice if Ringway made an organ in a cabinet. So we said to Ringway, is it possible if we design an organ, can we build it with you? And they said yes. So we got together with lots of exciting people. We got together with Lowry's Bill Curry, who helped us with many of the style accompaniments. Trevor and myself were heavily involved with the sounds and the registrations and the general sound of the instrument. The beautiful cabinets are made and the organs are all assembled for us by Orla in Italy, and of course the technology comes from Ringway in China. So it's a real compendium of wonderful ideas and worldwide experience of home organs. So we're absolutely thrilled with it. And of course, Excuse me, you heard there some of the fantastic theatre organ sounds. So we'll play a few more of those in a moment. I'll also show you in this session how to access some of those different voices. And we'll play some orchestral sounds as well. Oh, Wes is on. Hello, Wes. We've had tornadoes, heavy rain and high winds here in Dallas-Fort Worth area of Texas. Out of the bad weather now. Yes, I'm in America. They do have... sorry, hair in my mouth. They do have lots of interesting weather, excuse me, over there, especially in Chicago, where my wife is from. Excuse me, a cup of tea. Very, 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 when you go there, you know it's cold. You think it's cold here, you should try going there. Clifford's on, just back from the USA, where somewhat warmer. Oh, there you go. So he's bucking the trend. And Sue says, oh, hello, Sue and David up in the Northeast, saying, I'm enjoying the Orla Medina and it's very comfortable to sit at. That's nice to hear, Sue. Yep, absolutely. And Philip said, I would love to hear it. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow on the Maestro. It might give me a few ideas for registrations. We'll play that in just a few moments for you, Philip. Now, of course, we will have lots of Christmas songs in this session, but let's just have a quick guided tour of the panel of the wonderful Maestro. Now, of course, the panel looks somewhat similar to the previous flagship, the A2000. That's because it exactly is that panel. Because a lot of people said, we like the way the Ringway operates, we like the way it works. So we said, well, let's design it with the inclusion of the panel of the A2000. So the A2000 owners and RS800 owners and RS1000 owners, when they move up, everything's in the same place. Now, the sounds you were just hearing came from this bank here. This is Bank A. And inside Bank A, we have a set of factory theatre organ registrations. Bank B gives me a different set. I've got some nice home organ sounds. Very nice tones, which sound absolutely lovely. And also church organ sounds. Very pretty tones there. Bank C has choirs and strings and things. So lots of the, and so we get four banks, each with 16 registrations, and the registrations are very, very conveniently located in between the keyboards, numbered 1 to 16, with a memorise button at the end for storing your own settings, and also Bank D, button D at the end there, which lets you lock in the rhythm and tempo of your choice. So if you change registrations, that will stay in place. Now, even though this is a pre-owned instrument, it is in superb condition. Obviously, it's in stock, ready to tempt you with right now. And there's some fantastic part exchange offers on this one. It's only had home use. It comes included with it a complete two-year guarantee, parts and labour, and it comes with a bench, the owner's guide, a USB expansion pack, so everything comes with it. And of course, very importantly, when you obviously treat yourself to an organ from Allens, as many as you will know, myself, Trevor, Con and Lucy like to give you the very best service we can, not just with the purchase and the delivery of the instrument, but also through the years of your ownership with it, because it's very important that we help you get the very best. So any questions, 9 times out of 10, we normally can answer them, and if not, we'll find the answer. But we do know these organs very, very well. Anyway, so we've had a request from Philip to play Let It Slow, the. Maybe that should be Let It Snow times 3. But anyway, here we go. We'll enjoy that. And what I'll do is I'm going to pop on the screen now a little picture in picture. I'm going to show you the screen as I'm playing. You'll see different organ sounds coming. Let's use some of the internal voices. So this is the Ringway organ tone, which was specially designed for the Maestro, and well, it sounds well, more or less like this. Thank you. Well, two for the price of one there. The very first Christmas of all. That's rather appropriate. The very first pre-owned Maestro of all. And that is the sound of the Ringway Maestro organ tone. Absolutely beautiful. And Ringway did a great job producing that. Now, of course, I'd ask you to bear in mind that, of course, the sound that you're hearing on the live stream is obviously not obviously a true representation of how glorious this organ sounds, because we're using the outputs obviously to go into the computer. But the wooden cabinet makes a great, great sound. We've got a gorgeous speaker system, and it really does sound absolutely beautiful. So, and that's the thing, obviously, of having a proper wood cabinet really makes a big, big difference. So anyway, so very much thanks to Philip Russell there for suggesting Let It Snow times three. And those organ sounds are all built in. Another cup of tea. Let me show you how to how those organ sounds actually work. So what happens is, when I start over here, I press a button, funny enough, that says organ. And as you know, there are some organs that have tabs, some have drawbars. The Ringway has neither, because a lot of the times people, when they're playing organ sounds, they don't come from an organ playing background. They don't come from playing Wurlitzers or theatre organs or church organs. Many people who started the hobby didn't even have drawbars on their organ if they started maybe in the 90s or a little later, or maybe they've come from keyboards. So they tend to not use those kind of features. So we decided to go for a preset system. So when you press the organ button, you get on the bottom of the screen a big, big selection of organ sounds. And these are all preset, and you can move the octaves, you can fiddle around them. So the first one is called 16 and 8, so this is an upper voice one. And that just basically means it's like two tabs or two drawbars, the lowest and the next two along, the 8 foot. So if I go 16 and 4, that's now preset. Lovely tone. And then we've got 16 and 2. Now the 2 is the higher number, means the pipe shorter. And then we've got a full combination of 16, 8, 4 and 2. And of course we've got the sustain on, which is on the panel over here. And so that means I can then turn the sustain off if I want. And that gives me a much quicker sort of sound. We've got drawbar organs. So from those sort of 60 sounds and so on, we can then go to the next page. We've got cool organ. That kind of thing. We've got lower organ for nice lower organ sounds. Rock organs, church organs, and obviously the church organ sounds. We'll talk about those in a bit, and the accordions. But lots of lovely tones there. Now we have two voice sections. We've got the upper and the upper one and upper two. They're independent of each other. So what that means is you can then mix the organ sounds together to get different combinations, just as you would on a drawbar or a tab-based organ. So for example, I've got in my first sound 16 and 8. So that's the organ flutes, which sound like this. Okay, let's put the screen back on. And so if I then bring up the volume next door, I've got another sound which is called 16 and 4, but it's set an octave higher. So when I play here, it will sound like I'm playing up here. So now I've got the two sounds laid together. Listen to that. What a great sound there. Wonderfully rich, a wonderfully rich sound. And in fact, you can move the octaves of the voices to either side of concert pitch. So you get some very, very clever combinations. And again, we've set all these up. There we go. Really nice. We also have the ability to make that big, full chorded sound to bring on the melody on chord. So we have duet harmony. So that lets me play just one finger melodies, but I get a gorgeous extra note being added. And trio gives me the three-part harmony. really nice. So that's really lovely. So that is the sound of the Ringway organ tone. Absolutely beautiful. And when we go back, for example, to those theatre sounds that we started with excuse me, with Winter Wonderland, again, we have a button that says theatre, and that contains seven pages of sampled mixtures and individual ranks of church and theatre organs. So again, we can go for theatre organ one, theatre organ two. And as we work our way forward, we get different samples. So a little glockenspiel in there. So a nice little light reeds there. We've got tibias. So all the theatre sounds already mixed, ensembles. We've got tibia and vox humana, for example. We have a special guest in the room, everyone. Tam is here, everybody. Tam, you've got to come and give people a wave, my friend.
Are we live?
We are live on YouTube. It's Tam, everyone. He is back. It's the Tam lookalike. Yes, Tam has just returned from safely delivering some organs to customers. So well done, Tam. Is it cold outside, Tam?
It is, yeah. I've just come in the workshop to defrost.
Excellent. He's going to defrost. You're going to defrost your organ. Yes. Good to see you, Tam. And I'm sure Steve Homan says, nice to see Tam. Absolutely. Ken Percival has put, afternoon, Tom. Good afternoon, Ken. Good to see hear from you, sir. Do you have any of your registrations from your stick you produced recently to show off? Yes, the March and Broadway pack. I was going to talk about that in a little while when we talk about expansion packs. But yeah, absolutely. Tom, do you recall off the top of your head some of your favourite styles of Christmas music on the Lowry? Yeah, there's a lot on the Lowry you could use. The sleigh bells or sleigh ride in the Broadway menu. There's Lullaby, that's a nice style for Christmas waltzes. The big band ones are obviously good for all of those. Theatre Romance is a nice one. Yeah, so lots of styles, but as always with organs and things, always explore and things like that. So anyway, but actually, Ken actually very nicely leads us on now to the expansion pack. So when you get a Maestro or indeed any thing, actually I'll put this on the big camera, you get included with it a expansion pack. So this is the one that we include free of charge with all the Ringways. And this is just like an extra set of settings that come on the memory stick. And inside you have lots of information that gives you the description of the settings. So when you load these in, it's very, very straightforward on a Ringway. All we simply do is we start with a button over here that says load. Now, when I press the load button, I press the one that says registration. That then brings up on the screen this little screen here, and you just simply move a wheel up and down, choose the one you want. So I'm on Hobby 1, and I want the ballads. Okay, so I'm going to select that on the screen. So Hobby 1, confirm, and done. There it is in the organ, easy as that. So I press Bank B, and here's a Christmas favourite. Let's see if you know this one. Does anybody know that one? Maybe, I think everyone knows what it is, but it is Walking in the Air, of course, that is colloquially known as the theme from The Snowman. So yes, that was, those of you who don't know that in around the world, The Snowman is a 1980s hand-drawn animated cartoon about a boy who makes a snowman, and at night the magic happens and he comes to life and he goes to the North Pole and meets Santa and everything. And it's written, the music was written by a composer called Howard Blake, and the original music was sung by a choir boy called Aled Jones, although I don't think he sung it on the cartoon. I think he sang it on the release and got famous. There's a bit of a thing there that he's on the card. Anyway, Aled Jones is all grown up now and sings professionally in choirs, but that was his big hit in the 80s. So yes, but that's called Walking in the Air. It's a very, very well-known song here in Britain. So that was using Bank B in the file Hobby One in the Ringway expansion plan. That comes included with every Maestro, new or pre-owned, every A2000, RS800 and RS760. So that's the pack that you get. And it's the thing, when you get a pre-owned organ, the most important thing to remember is when you get it from us at Allen's, not only is it fully checked over by our trained engineer, who is one of them is, of course, Tam, our head man, it's also delivered by Tam and a colleague professionally and safely. The organs are all checked over, they're French polished if they need to be, and they also come included with, you also get the owner's guide, the pack, the USB, the bench, so everything's with it. That's the important thing. And most important of all, you get a lot of help and support with your purchase. We can't stress that enough. It's not just bye-bye after you buy the organ. We like to welcome everyone, as everyone on here on the chat is, we're all friends of Allen's and part of the Allen's family of organ and keyboard owners for sure. So everyone's saying, nice to see Tam. Sue King's put Satin Lady for Santa Baby on the Larry. That's a nice idea, Sue. Yeah, Satin Lady is a very good style. Alexander Trzynowski says fantasy and then something I think in Polish, which I can't read. Anyway, thank you for that. so where are we up to? Anyway, but we also have, we're now starting to expand on our Ringway packs, because as many of you know, for many years we've done USBs for Larry's, lots and lots of USBs for Larry's, which you can still buy, all available via our website, check them out on there. But of course we are now starting to make more packs for Ringways, and a recent one has been Marches and Broadway. So I've actually got those files on here. So this pack is available. It's compatible with 760, 800, A2000 and the Maestro Ringway, so the latest four organs. And it's been made by me, been a great pleasure to do these, and they are basically just Marches and Broadway sounds, which go very well, of course, with tunes of a festive nature. So let's load in these sounds. We've got marches, we've got polkas, we've got Broadway orchestra sounds, so we're going to enjoy some of those as we're going along. So if you've got any questions about the Maestro, wondering, would like to learn a bit more about it, what sort of the offers are, it's a fantastic organ, actually, for anyone wanting to upgrade, say, from a Lowry for something different. Maybe if you've still got at home something like a GA3 Technics or maybe an AR100 or maybe something like an Autogram Theatre or a Roland, a Telia. It's a fantastic organ because it's very, very nicely sized. It's 4 feet wide by 2 feet deep, beautiful cabinet, as we said, and it's the chance to have a phenomenal opportunity on a gorgeous pre-owned model. I say it's very exciting to have the first one back, and I say lots of people thoroughly enjoying their Maestros all across the UK. So anyway, here's a few sounds from this Marches and Broadway expansion pack, which I say is available. Just get in touch with us via the website, allensmusiccentre.co.uk. And here's a few festive numbers showing off some of the Broadway sounds. Here we go. There we go. That's just some of the Broadway sounds inside the registration pack. Marches and Broadway. 64 brand new registrations created for the Ringway range. And as I say, the full list of settings can be found on the website, Allen's Music Centre. Go to UK. Go to the organ menu. You'll see the Ringway organs in a list, and you will then see Ringway software. Click on that, and that will show you the two packs. Hello, Tom from David and Maria. Wow, hello, David and Maria. I haven't spoken to you for a long while. In a mild and blustery Portugal, north of the floods in Faro. Nice to hear from you both. Hope you're both well. Graham Williams says, not specifically for the Maestro, but what is the difference between a pad and lead voices? That's a good question, Graham. So the pads on the Ringway organs are for loading in MIDI files or audio files. So when you press one of the pads, it plays back what you loaded into it. So the idea of it is, if you're in a performance, when you load your registration in, you then haven't got to go back into the loading menu to find your MIDI file or your audio file to play your drum track, for example. It can be loaded in with the registration file, and that could be used for sound effects. And in fact, with the having pressed that button, with the marches and cheers, everyone. The marches and Ringway pack, Ringway marches and Broadway pack. We've actually got in some sample drum sounds, which I've sampled and put them in. And there's actually a batch that comes on the stick, so you can load in different ones if you want to use them on your registration. So a lead voice is, there's two lead voices, and that's where you basically put sounds for the upper keyboard or the lower split. A lead voice is just a sound, but it only plays one note. So there's two upper voices, two lead voices, two lower voices, and two pedal voices. One of the lead voices can go over the top of the other two sounds, and the other one can be made to go to a split sound on the lower keyboard. So in a short sort of question, they're completely different, Graham, because pads are for playing back things. The lead voices are actually voice sections which form part of your registration. Pete Stewart, hello Pete. Any thoughts on an upgraded version with a full-size pedal to go with the church organ sounds? I don't know, Pete. We have talked about that, but that might be something in the future. But we will let you know of any developments on the Maestro as things go along. But for the moment, we are going to be doing new Ringway packs during 2023, so that's going to be very exciting. So all very, very good stuff. I must also pull down the lid, because the lid looks gorgeous. I'm going to finish my tea before it gets cold. I do apologise drinking tea on a live stream, but I think we have to do this sometimes. The lighting is superb. You can adjust the lighting to two levels, but it's really bright, very clear and easy to read, and it's just a very comfortable organ. It's got the nice big feel of a big console organ without it being too big. It's very nicely sized, and as I say, it's the same. It's smaller than, for example, a Lowry Sensation. It's no bigger than an AR100, Technics GA3. So if you're looking to upgrade, especially maybe some of you watching who maybe haven't changed your organ for some decades, this is a superb update. Particularly if you come from a Yamaha or Technics background, because the feel and the panel and the layout of the organ will be something that will be very familiar to you. Lawrence Easdale. Lawrence, sorry. Hi, the time. Sorry I missed a bit. I was giving Oldie some money. Well, somebody has to, Lawrence, and hope you're enjoying your lovely instrument at home. One or two folks saying it's nice to have Tom back. Yes, thank you for that. It's nice to be back, but, you know, when I'm not here, I'm either not here for a reason, or I'm out helping Tam deliver, and it's nice to go out on the road and meet our customers and meet lots of new people as well, because we get new people who buy organs who just haven't bought an organ for years, and they see our live streams and think, that looks nice. So it's lovely to meet new people as well as our current family of Merva instrument owners. So absolutely lovely. Now, of course, with the pads, I mentioned that, of course, you can load in audio files, MP3s, or MIDI files. When you press the button, it plays whatever it is in there. So if it's a recording, for example, you could put on some sound effects, so bird noise or aircraft noise or whatever the application, or seashore, whatever the application might be for your song, your arrangement. You can play along with a pre-recorded song. You can transpose the organ to match. You can even increase and decrease the speed of the recording, and then and the pitch actually stays the same, which is very clever. You can play along with MIDI files and things like that. But you can also use the stick to record your own performances. So the memory stick can record Ringway performances, but it can also record audio, which means you capture the sound that you hear coming out the speakers onto the stick. It's ever so easy. You just literally press record and start. And then as soon as you press start, you start playing. And, pardon me, you then get a stereo studio quality recording on your memory stick, which you can then put in, say, play in your car, you can put it in your computer, email it, make a CD, do whatever you want. So it's bang up to date with all the latest technologies. Actually, while we're talking about sort of marches and polkas and things, there's some lovely orchestral sounds on this new pack, which go a bit like this. There we go, some lovely tones there coming from one of the latest orchestral packs that we've just produced for the Ringway range, entitled Marches and Broadway. Now, obviously, I've been playing with chords and pedals, so the question then comes is, well, what if I don't play the pedals? Well, you'll be very pleased to hear that the Maestro has in it a complete style rhythm accompaniment system, which we've managed to build in the same style of accompaniment system as the Lowry organs have. So the beauty is, if you load in, for example, let's say the Marches and Broadway pack, we've got the easy version of this. Okay, so let's pop in one of these settings here, the one that I just had, for example. Now when I play, if I put the easy button on, I get a full-blown orchestral accompaniment with that waltz, but we also have full intros and endings like this. if you prefer to play your chords lower down, you just play an octave lower and it moves the sound to the middle, you see. Because a lot of keyboard players like to play down there. So you can play in the bottom octave, no problems at all. You can even turn the rhythm off, look. And with the easy button, we can play with no pedals. You can play single finger. And what we did there, we decided to go with one of the most popular easy play systems for accompaniments, which was the one that Lowry used for many years. So you can move your hand down to the bottom, the octave shoots up, so it always sounds correct. That's what the easy button does. But we've got all the registrations set up for non-pedal players who like to play lots of accompaniment, and for players who don't use automatic accompaniment, which is really nice. Oh, Lawrence has put, yes, my Symphony Showcase has everything that you said about it. It's fabulous, very good. Pete Stewart, is the USB version 3, and what is the maximum size to be used? Do you know, Pete, I don't know what version it is. It's definitely going to be version 2. It might be version 3. Normally you can tell by the... I think it's probably version 2. Because USB 3 is quite a new thing in computing terms. USB 2, though, is more than fast enough for most streaming audio applications. In this case, recording to the USB. So I'd probably say it's version 2. I've used 16 gig plus on a Ringway. It doesn't really seem to bother it. I mean, to be honest with you, 8 gig is too much anyway, because we're not putting massively large files on there. But yeah, you're quite right in what you say. The Lowry's anything bigger than 8 gigabytes in a Lowry, the Lowry doesn't tend to like it too much, because we're not sort of playing 4K movies or doing lots of big image files. We're just literally loading in a very small, you know, in computing terms, it's a drop in the ocean in terms of the registration data that you load in. So we tend to think with Lowry's, but 8 gig is about the max. But the Ringways, they don't have any problems at all, as far as we know. But as I say, we tend to stick to 8 or 16 gig sticks anyway with Ringways, because if you fill that up, you've heck of a lot of settings for sure. So there we go, folks, all very, very nice. And of course, the great thing with the accompaniment section is that we have intros, endings, we have variations A and B, two fill-ins. And what's great is with the D button at the end, you can override the pre-programmed registrations and tempos and make your own choices and then have that stay in place. So for example, let's say I was going to play, what should we go for? Mary's Boy Child. Okay, so I go to Latin. Or ballroom, and I'd have a look through and I'd find something Rumba Ricky. Let's try that one. So put my easy button on, let's give this a whirl, gang. Here we go. It does help, of course, if you press the right button. Now I've got to remember how that song goes. That's the one. Okay, so I set the tempo. Now the thing then is, I'm going to want to change to a different registration. But the thing is, I won't want the rhythm and the tempo to change. I want that to stay in place. So once I've made my selection, I press the D button at the end, and that disables these buttons. So it means they can still change their sounds and settings, but they're not allowed to adjust the rhythm style and the tempo to what they have set in them. So it's an override feature. Not only is it for the bank that you're on, but it's for any of the banks that are loaded in the organ. So if I'm sewing on bank D and then there's a setting in bank A that I like, I can move to that by pressing A and the number in question, and that rhythm will stay in place. So here we go then with a little bit of Mary's Boy Child. Oh, that's a nice rhythm. That one's called Rumba Ricky. A nicer compliment, that one. So you can see there, as we were playing, I was making my changes, making my selections on the registration buttons. But because we had the D disable button on, these buttons were not allowed to change their rhythm and tempo. They could change everything else, but that was locked in. And I was also adding some harmony there to my melody hand as we went through. Pete says, yes, the smaller size USBs are getting harder to come by. Yeah, you can still get them. There are, you can get USBs manufactured to any specification that you want, but places like Amazon and eBay would normally have them. The only thing with memory sticks is it's finding one that will work with the organ. I mean, the Lowry's are, they're a bit picky with sticks because they're not like a regular computer, whereas the Verzi's and the Ringway's have a slightly more standardised computer system. In the Verzi, as you know, runs on Windows 10, so there's no problems there. But the Lowry system is slightly different, so we tend to say with Lowry's, don't go above 8 gigs, and that tends to work very, very well. It's just my microphone. Well, again, there we go. That's 50 minutes. Sue King says, I've been chatting to Denise Masters in Australia. Yes, we know Denise. She's a regular on our live streams. And she says she can only have one sound on her RS600. Is that right? No, the 600 also has two upper and two lower voices. You have to press, there's a button on the panel that says voice one and voice two, and you have to press it on to engage right two. The thing with the 600 is it doesn't have a graphical screen. It has like a text display screen, so it's a little trickier to work out things about. But yeah, but you can mix two voices on that organ. It's voice one and voice two, and you just have to press the, it's like a, because they only have one upper voice panel section, whereas on here we've got the two, so we know that the buttons for the second voice are there, the buttons for the first voice here. But on the 600, because it was a very small organ, they do it on the RS760. You can have two voices on the top, but it says voice 1/2. You have to press it to switch in the system the second voice. It's one of the things of when you have a smaller organ, the thing that has to be made smaller is the organ itself. And the only way you can do that is by, if you remove these two panel sections, you've then saved that much space on the panel, which means you can make the cabinet smaller. So it's a trade-off of the ease of the function of the organ versus its size. So when people move from the 760 to the RS800, the first thing they always say is, it's so much easier to operate, and because I've also got a really big colour screen. And then they move up to the A2000, they go, wow, this is great, I've got the same panel, but it's bigger and brighter, I've got a bigger screen, a better sound. And then they move up to the Maestro and they go, great, the panel's the same as my 2000, I didn't have to relearn anything. But I've got all these new sounds and all these new styles of an even more impressive sound and a beautiful cabinet to go with it. So it's a bit like saying that with the Lowry's and the Verzi's. There's nice continuity in the thing. So no, she's not right in that sense, but if she reads her owner's manual, she will find a section there about selecting voices. Yes, so there we are. Pete Stewart, he said, this could possibly be a problem in the future with the Lowry's. Well, not really, Pete, because there's always going to be 8 gigabyte sticks. I mean, if needs be, we can get 8 gigabyte sticks manufactured. You just go to a USB manufacturer and say, make me 100 memory sticks with 4 gigs trips in, and providing that the software of the chip inside is compatible. We used to do that years ago. We used to have memory sticks actually made until it became more cost effective not to do that. But the thing with the stick manufacturers, they want you to order 10,000 sticks, not 100 as we do. But we found a particular brand of stick that we use on a fairly regular basis, which we know works with the thing. So the Ringways and the Verzi's are not quite so picky, but it's just the nature of the beast. It's just organs are computers, but they're not necessarily like a Windows or a Mac where they've got the ability to read every stick. And sometimes it's not the organ, it's the stick itself that's the issue. It's because the stick has a chip in that has software on, and if that isn't quite compatible with the organ, then that's when... I remember years ago we had a memory stick which was really bizarre, where you could save registrations on the Lowry, but it wouldn't let you record songs. Really bizarre. But as I say, mostly the plain plastic colour ones that we tend to supply with organs work absolutely fine. So it won't be a problem, Pete, because there's always going to be memory sticks around. So, and every time we get an organ traded back in, we often get sticks come back with it, which of course are cleaned off and then recycled and reused with the next organ. Sue says, thanks for explaining that. Denise will be watching on a catch-up. She's 10 hours in front of us, therefore asleep at the moment. Yes, she probably will be, unless she's a night owl, Sue. Yeah, absolutely. Well, everyone, I shall say thank you so very, very much for your company this afternoon. We will be back next week for more musical fun with a presentation of a different organ. But I hope you've enjoyed my presentation today, exploring some of the features and sounds of the gorgeous Ringway Maestro. We're so proud of this here at Allen's. This really was our baby right from the beginning. And everyone who's got one of these is over the moon with it. And as I say, we're thrilled to have a pre-owned one come in. And I say the owner of this one just simply decided to have a change, nothing more than that. Many of our customers just have an organ for a year or so and then just want to change, just no more reason than that. So the gentleman's moved on, but it's got great condition. And as I say, it is available at a superb price. And of course, as you know, here at Allen's, we are well known for our generous part exchanges. So if you want to know a bit more about it or maybe explore some options there, just do get in touch via the website, allensmusiccentre.co.uk. You can phone us here in the UK on 01493 842887 or just get in touch via the website by sending us an email. But anyway, but thanks so much for your company, folks. We will say thank you so much. I'll be on my YouTube channel tomorrow, Keyboard Skills Pro, for a Christmas show, playing some music on there, lots of Christmas songs. So that's going to be a good fun and a busy time of year for me, because obviously, I work here at Allen's part-time, but busy teaching, and of course it's pantomime season, busy with rehearsals at the moment, and then January is, all this kind of, that's 30 quid right there. I kid. But anyway, folks, thank you so much for watching. Let's finish off with some more tones on the wonderful Ringway Maestro. And I've no idea what I'm going to play, but I know what I can play. We'll do some of the marching sounds. Here we go, a little bit of Jingle Bells. So thanks for watching, everyone. And don't forget, here on the YouTube channel, Lowry UK, we've got videos on Lowry organs, Versey organs, Ringway organs. Do hit the subscribe button. Do ding the Liberty Bell so you know when things are going. If you want to keep in touch a bit more with us, if you go to the website, on the main page down the bottom, there's a sign-up form for our electronic newsletter, which we send out regularly. So you can sign up for that with your email. And there's lots of exciting news about new organs, pre-owned instruments, new software packs, Music Extravaganza 2023, which we're currently booking. Organising, I should say, for next year, which is very exciting. And lots of exciting things going on. But thanks so much, everyone. Keep playing your organs, keep playing. And if any of you got any questions about the Maestro, please do get in touch. So I'll say thank you very much, keep warm, and see you very soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.